Have you ever read a really good story? Okay, maybe you don't like reading. Have you ever seen a really good movie with great writing? At the very least, you caveman, you have heard someone tell a good story. Great, so we all agree, we have all heard, seen, or read a really good story. Now let's break down what that good story looks like. You have a main character, and this main character follows a journey, or a plot. Along this plot, you are introduced to other characters and their environment. Lastly, and most importantly, they are confronted with conflict or their great struggle that they will go back and forth with, leading to the climax of the story, where either the main character wins over the struggle or their struggle gets the best of them. Then, the remaining parts of the story are either the fallout of the climax or filler information that is necessary for closure to that story. Boom! That's it. Those are the key factors to a good story. So imagine that story you really, really enjoy, and imagine hearing it for the first time. Except hearing it from the beginning, you hear it at the start of the climax. How does that change the story, and your understanding the role of the main character and their importance to that story? Did you know that this is how most people interact with the Christian story? It's true. Most people interact with or have only ever heard the climax of the Christian story, which is the resurrection. Jesus's resurrection is the climax to the greatest story ever told. It's the greatest story ever told because it involves everyone who ever lived, me, you, Adam, Eve, and the people to come after us. It involves the entirety of the real world, not a fantasy world. It involves the dirt you walk on. It's about everything. I mean everything being put back in order and in its rightful place according to its creator. So imagine hearing Jesus, the main character of the story, resurrecting from the dead. You should want to know more as to why that's important and how it became necessary. He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee that the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified on the third day, rise. That's Luke 24. So imagine hearing that and only that. How confusing is that? And what do you have to go off to understand the reality and depth of that? This passage is good news, but it means so much more when you have greater context to it. Because we do not have the context of Jesus' resurrection, we either don't let the reality of it sink in, because the weight of it doesn't hit us very hard, or we become disinterested because we lack the understanding of its significance. You have at least heard the climax of the greatest story ever told. I believe it is in your greatest interest to go back and look why Jesus' role was so important, because the resurrection, the key to understanding the biblical story, becomes the key to our story as well, the key to a new way of understanding and living in the world.